Okay. Let's get to work here. So, where I last left off, our Firekeeper Shrine got annihilated. And unfortunately, that means I am gonna have a harder time dealing with the upcoming areas. So we now know where we need to go in Blighttown. But we're gonna have to get through there, because we can no longer use Firelink Shrine as our convenient location. So basically, the blacksmith is really our only way of doing things now. We can't kindle this fire anymore.
Well, I don't.
So we're gonna have to go move on and head back into Blighttown. And deal with the problems there. Because we need to light the Well, we need to ring the bell in Blighttown. And the only alternate way of doing things would be to head to other places, and I'm not willing to do that. So we go through the new Londo ruins. Up the stairs and to the right. Switch to my heavy soul arrow. Like, I now have remedy, so I can get rid of the poison if it becomes an issue. Like, keep in mind, it takes three heavy soul spears to actually kill these guys. So, I mean, heavy soul arrows, that's what they're called. And it takes, like, eight soul arrows to actually kill these guys. Like, we start with 60. So if what one hit, so it takes about 7 to 8 to kill the big orcs here. So there is that. All right, so now we need to head down into Blighttown. And this entire place is just suffering in game form. Like, if I could somehow skip Blighttown, I'd do it. And somehow I missed my shot there. Being attacked while how do I get down from here exactly? I see, so I'm gonna have to time this. I'm assuming if I didn't time that right, I'd die. Okay. Come on. Need to cast Remedy. Receive remaining power of Dark Spirit. Humanity acquired. Butcher knife. Well, there goes my, stuff. Oh, that's a problem. You can't see those guys. Yeah, good to know the rock there can... Okay, not cool. Great club. Thank you. purple moss clumps are just... absolutely essential. Alright, I'm assuming I have to go into this pit here. That's really sketchy. Quelaag's domain. Okay, good to know. Whoa, okay, oh, we get, ally here. Maneater Mildred. We'll take it. Looks like it's time to fight a boss. Oh. Oh dear God. This really is Florida. Oh. Oh God. Don't give me that smile. Oh, nope, I'm on fire. I'm gonna run out of arrows. And I'm out of arrows. Nope, wrong thing. Come on, get up. There we go. Barely won. Soul of Quelaag. Twin humanities. Okay, 20,000 souls. Nice. It only cost us all of our magic, and... barely surviving. So is there some sort of hidden area back here that I'm not privy to? No? Okay. Like, I'm just looking for, some sort of fire. Because I'm probably going to have to rely on just my sword at this point, and that's not good. So what happens if I pull this? I don't think anything will happen. Oh. The bell rings. Okay. Oh, the gate opens. That'll be convenient later. Ring the bell of Qualeg's domain. Alright, so let's go, head on out of here. Alright, I guess I can just go down through here, because I don't have any other way to go. Like, if I use homeward... Oh. Demon runes. Light bonfire. So, 1 and 2 endurance, and 1 into strength. I'm gonna need to get myself a bunch of Titanite shards, because apparently I can reinforce my armor, and I haven't been doing that. This is not worth it. I should not have done this. All right, so, this is apparently the place we're not supposed to be. So we'll head up out of Blighttown here and head all the way back up to the surface. But we're gonna have to come back down here eventually. Because apparently, I just stumbled into an in-game area, and we're not supposed to go that way. Apparently, I should have just used Homeward Bone. Yeah, no, we aren't dealing with that. We're saving my soul arrows for when we actually need them. No point in sticking around here. We're just gonna die if we do that. And I can take off Remedy again. Now the only way to go is up. We're done with Florida, so we can just get out of here. No more Florida. No thank you. I'm not gonna add people on Discord. That's not how we do things here. I respect the hustle, though. Sometimes we just have, like, locking on issues here. Like, two hits is enough to temporarily stagger them. But not by a significant amount.
You ring the... That is incredible. It's noisy. This is no lock. Damn. The... Maybe.
Yeah, not sure what that guy's deal is. Oh, well. What is going on here?
Was it you who rang the Bell of Awakening? I am the Primordial Serpent, King Sikafrant, close friend of the great Lord Gwyn, chosen undead who has rung the Bell of Awakening. I wish to elucidate your fate. Do you seek such enlightenment?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Very well. Then I am pleased to share. Chosen undead, your fate is to succeed the great Lord Gwyn, so that you may link the fire, cast away the dark, and undo the curse of the undead. To this end, you must visit Anor Londo and acquire the Lord Vessel.
I understood none of that.
Please, is it something? Those who seek the realm of lords must brave Sen's fortress, a deadly house of traps. Many have gone before you, but none have returned. Fate has chosen you. But proceed with caution. Farewell, chosen undead. I remain here and await thee.
What is King Seeker Framp's purpose? Interesting.
I've scoured near and far. Where could she have gone, my lady?
No, no point in going that way. Hey, I've gotten pretty decent at this game. Let me think here. So we need up to 6. Yeah, okay, that's a pretty expensive investment. I'm not gonna lie.
I won't be seeing you then. Be careful.
Alright. We'll see how much we need to level up, and then we will move on. I need 2,500 more souls in order to level up. Okay. Now I can level up again. Level up strength because we're gonna keep running out of magic. But I will be right back. I'm gonna get something to drink. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and head on in, but I'm gonna feel underleveled, I guarantee it. Oh hey, the guy's gone. Oh god. Well, I just got killed by an invisible assassin. Well, that's not very nice. Okay, that's 500 runes per. And we go past the ragdoll bodies. Now something just died. Soul of Brave Warrior. Are these guys really just statues? Yeah, they're really just statues. Okay. Okay, we got this bullcrap. Okay, yep, this is not gonna be an option. We're gonna need a ranged method if we're gonna do this. Alright, equipment. I have that crossbow somewhere, right? We're gonna need some bolts.
Well, you need.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to start stockpiling, I don't like using the heavy, crossbow there. Oh, interesting. They automatically move around the trap. I do wish the ragdoll physics weren't a thing. Oh, nope. Nope, that is rolling in the wrong direction, game! Game? What is going on? What was going on there? Like, I was rolling backwards and it said I was rolling forward. Almost ran into the trap again. Yeah, okay, we can't aim with this. Crossbow, you're a waste of time. Where's my bow? Wow, okay. I am perfectly willing to play the long game. Yeah, remind me, I'm gonna have to start upgrading my bow. Because I can already see the damage dropping off from, it being used. Like, I've gone through more than 50 arrows at this point. Okay, there we go. Clearly some sort of trap here. Alright, what's the trap here? Giant rolling ball of doom? No trap? Oh. There's the trap. Nope. Yep. Okay. So, okay. Yeah, we have an idea of what we need to do. So to start with, we're gonna need more runes. More runes and better equipment. And there's only really one place we can go to grind at this point. So, we're gonna have to take a quick trip to the forest here and power grind. So we're gonna need to grind. So this is where we go to beat the crap out of people. This is where having higher dexterity would actually help me. I'm gonna need to level up dexterity at this point. Like, I need to get to a point where I can just easily knock these guys out. Like, we get 2,000 runes for killing this guy every time. Which is great. Alternatively, so we're gonna level up a number of things here. As well as gather runes to get the equipment we need. Basically need to increase our dexterity so I can cast spells faster. Of course, it does not help when the game, like, turns you in directions it's not supposed to, which is quite frequently a problem more than I would like. Like, I get my dexterity up, I can do a lot more. But we're pretty much just gonna spend our time, like, knocking this guy out until I can consistently kill him without dying. Because every level of dexterity is gonna allow me to cast spells faster. Okay, this is another problem. The distance on their spells is horrifically inconsistent. So much so that it's actually a problem I'm gonna have to consider. But the alternative is for me to just, like, except the fact that, like, oh, hey. Yeah, we're just gonna have to accept the fact that, this guy cheats. When he does, it's a problem. But we still need that 2,000 runes per. So I just have to kill this guy, like, about 100 times. Because doing extra damage doesn't do as much good. But being able to outpace his casting speed certainly would put me at an advantage. Because right now my big problem is he can outcast me with ease. But also, a better bladed weapon would require more dexterity and strength. So it's only, like, super minor. God, I hate the inconsistency on locking on. This game. and there's nowhere for me to get a better catalyst either. Like, there's no obvious point for me to get a better sorcery catalyst. Like, I can't upgrade the sorcery catalyst at the blacksmith, and I can't upgrade it anywhere else, it seems. But I'm getting into the rhythm of just killing them quickly. Yeah, he sort of seems to, like, at some point, just get locked into just, like, wanting to spam his spell. And it takes 15,000 runes. Like, every time it adds on an extra 1,000 runes to level up. Just being able to do everything slowly over time here. Kinda nice. So we're probably gonna have to alternate between strength and dex leveling. And the game turned me in the wrong way. Truly, the camera is my biggest enemy. Nope. Thank you. Like, I probably should also be specking into, more intelligence. And we're just a bit off, but... Oh well. Like, how much is it for me to, like, be able to wield that katana, exactly? Because we got a katana, and, like, it would be better than what I currently have by a significant amount. But it requires 20 dexterity. But bleed would be really nice. Wait, we get a better sorcery catalyst? Yeah, hold on a moment. You mean I've had a better sorcery catalyst for a while? Like, it's a heavy sorcery catalyst, so I'm not sure what the difference would be. Like, if anything, this seems to be worse. Somehow. Yeah, this sorcery catalyst is somehow worse. Yeah, that's somehow worse. That's disappointing. Well, I think we'll go full on dexterity for killing these guys. Yeah, like we do more damage with this, even though that other one should be better. Like, if it was a strength requirement, dexterity wouldn't be a problem for the katana. But, because we need that strength requirement... going back to the wizard duels. The speed at which this guy does things is our big problem. We're just gonna level up Dex until I can use the katana, and then I'll two-hand the katana to kill these guys for efficiency's sake. Because now I'm just kind of baiting the guy until he actually gets off his butt and gets down here. I'm having an easier time just meleeing him than I am doing this whole, like, wizard duel thing. Problem is they don't like to, get down here. And this entire thing is pretty much a risk. Yeah, after I finish this tonight, I'm just gonna go ahead and do most of my grinding off stream. Because, my way of playing through this is not the right way of doing this. Like, intelligence build should be a post-game thing. At least in my opinion. And critical hits are a thing, by the way. But you can tell this guy's using soul arrows for some things. And it's painfully obvious, too. Like, there he's using Soul Arrow. Like, it'd probably also help if I leveled up my armor. But I need souls for that as well. Yeah, okay, don't try to cast Soul Arrow on this guy. I mean, heavy soul arrow. You're just gonna get outsped. And this guy is just, like, absolutely bonking me right now. Yeah. Like, occasionally we'll have moments like this where the AI just, like, goes to town on us. And when it does, it's really bad for us. Look at this, like, now he's just, like, somehow, like, outpacing us on everything. Because, like, there's no place to upgrade sorcery catalysts, as far as I'm aware. Yeah, there's no place to upgrade my sorcery catalyst. They get a super cheaty range and speed buff that we don't get. Because they're casting heavy soul arrow. Which I am not. Okay, that's not a lot of souls. Yeah, that's kind of a waste, actually. Like, that'll get us to where I want to be faster, though. Now, we're gonna need to find a soul. Well, actually, what I need to do is I need to grind up to, like, 99 arrows and then use a rune exploit later. But I don't want to do that at the moment. Yeah. Alright, come on. There we go. So once I get to 20 dexterity, which will take a while, level 60 ought to be good enough for me to be able to move on. Oh hey, like, the scam artist who followed me trying to get me to add them on Discord earlier just unfollowed. Nice. And two-handing is, like, absolutely essential if I want to do damage at this point. Yeah, that soul arrow is gnarly. Yeah, so dexterity is really kind of only useful at 30 to 45 in terms of spellcasting, but we're still working on getting it up to wield that katana anyways. We had a pretty good thing going until we, like, lost the lock-on. Which is a pretty consistent thing for tonight. Like, we beat one boss tonight, and we're going on a bit of a level-grinding spree so I can use a better weapon. So, objectively speaking, we are making progress, just not very quick progress. Okay, why can I not lock onto him? Come on. There we go. Like, sometimes this game, man. Oh, I can reinforce it again? Oh. No, probably shouldn't have done that. Like, even though it's a long sword, it's still not gonna do as much damage as, like, say, a katana over time. It's gonna take me, like, 80,000 runes to be able to use this katana. But it also gets my, spell casting up, so I guess that's a win. And what is up with you, dog? Like, aren't you supposed to be, like, the wizard? Yeah, okay, this guy has more range than I do. Like, I'ma just say this now. This guy has more range than I do. So, I have no way of actually, like, casting anything other than Soul Arrow on him. Yeah, his attacks also curve around the tree, so if you're not, like, directly in front of a tree, you're kind of in trouble. This is still faster than, like, dealing with the dragons. Like, there's no automatic farming way of doing this. But the guy's built-in magic resist is kind of a nightmare to deal with. There we go. There we go. Yeah, easiest way to grind is to just get strong enough to kill these guys at this point. Because alternative, there's only two ways we can really farm up souls. And neither of them work out for us all that well. Probably just gonna go until we reach, the desired level of stamina. And then level up strength to, like, 20. Well, I rolled into that. Like, keep in mind, my killing of this guy is not consistent. Like, ideally speaking, you'd get to a point where you just have, like, a weapon where you can just one-shot him. Like, I have this, black type, black knight greatsword, which, would be cool if I could use it, but I can't. The way strength works in this game is kind of wonky. Dark souls. Really darkening my soul. Praise the Raven. Okay. So, two more levels and I can wield that katana, which is gonna be about 40,000 more runes. No, three more levels. That'll be about 60,000 more runes. If I switch over to this here, like, it specifically says I can't use it. Even while two-handing, I'm not able to properly use it. Like, it is strictly a stat requirement. So we need 60,000 runes. I mean, souls. Thank you. If I get to a point where I can just one-shot these guys, that'd be great. Like, keep in mind, there's another one of this guy around here that's, like, worth just as much. But he is just as hard to kill. And once I reach the 2-hour mark, I'm gonna call it quits for the night, because I really don't want to do this all day. Because I've sort of hit my, like, amount of footage I can record for a weak point, because I do set myself like a time limit on how long I play games. It's more of a health thing. You know what? We're gonna call it quits for tonight. Because my arm is getting tired here, and now is a good time to stop. But we do have, like, a good system going here where I can grind.